You're listening to Radio Lab.
Radio Lab.
From
WNYC.
There were Soviet horses that were locked up in a stable.
And the horses panicked and broke out of the stables. Hundreds of them.
And they just started running.
Rushing to get away from the fire.
Right.
You have hundreds of horses bolting through this flaming forest.
Heading towards the open space ahead, which was the lake.
And all at once, they burst out of the forest and go barreling into the lake, stampeding one on top of the other as they all get deeper and deeper.
Up to their heads.
And it is at this moment when they enter the lake that, according to the story, something very weird happens. In the blink of an eye,
the lake snaps them shut.
It just freezes.
Suddenly turns to ice.
With a bang. It goes from water to ice.
Email at our radio show near the end of the last school year from a 14-year-old.
Hello?
Hey, is this Annie?
Yeah.
I called her up at her house in California and asked her to read it.
Mm-hmm. It says, "Dear This American Life, I just escaped the whitewashed, brick-walled, iron-gated prison that is commonly known as middle school, and I'm finally out for good. But in all the time I've listened to your show, I've never heard an episode devoted to what goes on inside the walls of a middle school. I hope you'll think about it." Anonymous?
Yeah, you signed it anonymous, but then you actually, your email was signed with your name.
Yeah.
The book revolves around her relationship with Robert Mapplethorpe. The album that made her famous, Horses, had an iconic photo of her taken by Mapplethorpe. He later became known.
Patti Smith, welcome back to Fresh Air. At the beginning of your memoir, we get a glimpse of how different your life might have been.
I was a lower middle class kid. My family had no money. There was no room in our small house where there were already four kids, including myself, living. I would have had to get a job in a factory, ask my mother to help me, and she was already.
From PRX, this is the Moth Radio Hour. I'm Catherine.
She introduced herself and said she was the representative of a world figure and a Nobel laureate, someone who was suspected to have a viral hemorrhagic fever, and she was calling to ask if I would consult on the case. I was 32 years old. I had just opened my office. The phone never rang. I had no patience. In fact, I remember staring at the phone, trying to will it to ring. She arranged a conference call, and in 10 minutes, I was transported through the telephone wires to a small hospital in Calcutta, India, where I found out for the first time that the patient was Mother Teresa. And on the line were her two main Indian doctors.
Entering a group of Aboriginal runners in this legendary race called the Leadville Trail 100. It's a 100-mile race through the Rocky Mountains.
Huh.
They entered the race, and they just obliterated the field.
Wow.
And not only did they win, they had been given new running shoes to wear. They didn't like them, so they went to the town dump and carved out sandals from discarded tires, strapped them on, and ran 100 miles in them. So essentially what they did was they preserved the adaptations.
Thank you.
glass of wine. I have been working so hard all week long, and my work is never done until Weekend Bob gets here. Then I finally like try to not work.
Try.
But can you do it? I'm at my wit's end of like how much work I have to do.